an explorative person. I guess that many people would like to be a little bit more like you. It was about 1 year ago that we first met. You wanted to do a research internship, and Miriam, one of your other supervisors, and I were looking for two students who could analyze a different aspect of a tripping study I was involved with at the time. You paired up with Kirsten, who you didn't know before, and started a very interesting collaboration where you would use each other's qualities optimally. Good collaboration skills and using each other's strengths are, again, trademarks of you that many people would like to have a little bit more. The aim of your research internship was to answer the question if we are able to distinguish false from near false and no false in elderly subjects. A highly relevant question because we think that an increase in the number of near false is a strong predictor of the number of future real falls. And if we can predict falls, then we can implement preventive measures and possibly prevent the serious negative consequences of falls in elderly. To make sure that we would measure near falls and not just walking around of our participants, we used an experimental setup in which we could pop up an obstacle to suddenly trip our subjects. It would have been nice to show a video, but I didn't know this possibility existed in this room. These trips were comparable to a trip that is experienced when walking on the street and tripping over loose pavement, for instance. To make sure that people would not really fall on the ground if they were unable to regain balance, you or Kirsten would pull on a rope to move an overhead cart, which had ropes attached to the subject that would prevent them from hitting the floor. Very long sentence. A very important task, but with unfortunate side effects, as you and Kirsten developed sore hands from pulling the rope several hundred times each measurement. Finally, at some point, I brought a pair of gloves. But then you told me that you have a rubber allergy, and we were both unsure if rubber was used in the glove. After some discussion and some thinking, you decided to take the risk as it was impossible for us to get a new set of gloves in time and you didn't want to disrupt the measurement schedule. Also, you felt very safe since we were very close to the Vu Medical Center, which seemed to be a very safe hospital at the time. The first time you used gloves during a measurement, I was very nervous, and during the first 30 minutes, I looked more at you to see if you got red and swollen than the subjects that we were trying to trip. Fortunately, there was no rubber in the glove, and you didn't have to visit the hospital. Double luck here. After the measurement period, your two strongest characteristics became very clear. First, you are a very independent person, at least as far as I know. Always trying hard to figure things out by yourself, and this is a great characteristic because you will learn a lot this way. I hope you will remain independent, but also that you will seek out assistance if needed, because there are a lot of people who would like to help you. Your independence didn't help you when you needed to do the difficult statistical analysis, which was completely unfamiliar to you and not at all easy to understand for anybody. But your second characteristic, you are very determined also. And some help resulted in a successful execution of the chosen statistical analysis. After all this hard work, the results you produced together with Kirsten showed that distinguishing false from near false and no false seems doable. Although the results of the parameters we chose were not convincing enough, and more research is probably needed. I'm happy for you that you finished your internship and, of course, your master's program. But now I do miss your emails, full of enthusiasm and positivism, and always ending with your name in pink and a cartoon of a blonde lady in short skirt. Since you're obviously not blonde, and I've never seen you wear such a short skirt, I often wondered who that girl on the picture is. but I always forgot to ask. Therefore, I'm writing the question into the speech, so I cannot forget, and I will finally get the answer during the upcoming drinks. Also, on behalf of Miriam and Sietse, I congratulate you with obtaining your master's degree of the Faculty of Human Movement Sciences. Enjoy this day with your family and friends, and enjoy the drinks and celebrate because you deserve it. Diani, well done.